Hello, and welcome to the first in a series of tutorials by NullState. Over the following year, we are going to help you get acquainted with two programming languages, SuperCollider and MaxJitter. After laying some basic groundwork, we will show how these languages can be used in tandem to create stunning, interactive audiovisual works of art. We will begin by exploring SuperCollider, a programming language specializing in audio synthesis, digital signal processing, live coding, and algorithmic music composition. I, Benjamin D. Whiting, shall be your guide on this journey exploring its various ins and outs, the first step of which being the successful installation of all components of the language on your operating system of choice. For your convenience, I have provided a timeline in the description below that will allow you to jump straight to segments concerning installation on macOS, Windows, and Linux. Installing SuperCollider on macOS is a straightforward process. First, head to supercollider.github.io and click on the Download tab. You will be confronted with a list of packages to download for every supported platform. Look under the heading that says Mac for relevant links to downloads for the current version, 3.10.0 at the time of recording, and the three most recent legacy major revisions. A brief note before we proceed. If you're running a version of macOS older than El Capitan, which is 10.11, you will not be able to run SuperCollider 3.10 on your system. There may be a way to build it from source and get it working, but that is beyond the scope of this tutorial. This is not clearly specified on the download webpage, but trust me, I've tried installing it on multiple computers running Mavericks and/or Yosemite, and the program immediately crashes upon launch. If you're running SuperCollider on a version newer than Snow Leopard but older than El Capitan, the version you should install is 3.9.3. Don't worry, this version is still plenty current and will not affect progress through this tutorial series in any way. One further note, because there is a small but vibrant music-making PowerPC Mac community, I feel it prudent to mention that the most recent version Tiger and Leopard capable in PowerPC Macs can run is 3.4.4, which is the last available universal binary. As of December 2018, however, it is no longer directly linked to on the SuperCollider webpage. For those interested, I'll post a link to the file in the description below, but be careful. This version is 7 years old and does not reflect a number of subtle and not so subtle changes in the language and appearance that have been introduced over the years. You will still be able to follow along in the tutorial up to a certain point, and it is still a very usable and sophisticated iteration of this programming language, but you will undoubtedly run into issues along the way requiring potentially frustrating workarounds. Moving on, click on whichever version is the newest your operating system supports, in my case it's 3.10, and wait for the download to complete. So once the download's finished, simply unzip the file, presuming your internet browser didn't already take care of that for you. As you can see, Safari has. So what you need to do next is open Downloads and look for the SuperCollider folder. Now take that folder and drag it over to your main applications folder, like so. Now in Applications, find the folder, open it, and then right-click on SuperCollider. Click Open. You need to do this so that macOS will trust the application going forward. It's verifying. Click on Open here. There we go. Just wait for a little bit, and voila! You should see the IDE in all of its glory. Our next test is to make sure we can boot the server. To do this, go to the Server menu and select Boot Server. If you do so and the various measurements within the little widget you can see here at the bottom right of the IDE light up green, then all is well. Now for the true Hello World test, type the following on one line and then press Shift Return. So just type what I'm typing here. I will also post the code in the description below. Sign OSC. You have to make sure that the capitalization is exactly as what's displayed here. Otherwise, it will not work. Press Shift Return and it's a sine wave. At some point, you'll get tired of hearing it, so go ahead and press Command Period to stop the sound. If you don't hear a sound and have made sure your volume is not muted and all of your output settings and audio MIDI setup are correct, or something else is amiss, then post a description of what is happening in the comments below and I'll help the best I can. The act of installing SuperCollider on Windows is no more inherently difficult than the procedure for macOS, though depending on your particular hardware, software, or even network setup, one can be presented with a myriad of challenges to overcome. By the way, it should go without saying that a good sound card and audio driver is necessary for the best results with the lowest latency. Some tweaking in driver and/or equipment acquisition may be in order to achieve the best results. Mosey on to supercollider.github.io. And once you're there, click on the Download tab. You will be confronted with a list of packages to download for every supported platform. Look under the heading that says Windows for links to downloads for the current version, which is 3.10.0. and the three most recent legacy versions. The first thing that may stick out to you is the greater depth of choice than what is found under the Mac or Linux tabs. This is because each major version of the Windows port of SuperCollider, beginning with version 3.8, comes in both 32 and 64-bit flavors. To determine which version you need, right-click on the Start menu icon and click on System. And yes, for various reasons, I'm still running the often maligned Windows 8.1 in this day and age. As you can see, my Mac Pro is a 64-bit system, so I am free to choose between a 32-bit and a 64-bit version of the program. If I were running a 32-bit system, on the other hand, I would need to select the 32-bit executable. By the way, don't pay any attention to whether or not a certain version comes with Supernova. It's not important for any segment of this tutorial, and there's no reason to limit yourself to the 32-bit version of 3.8 just to use this alternative server that can, with extra effort on the user's part, execute multiple threads simultaneously. If later on you decide to experiment with getting the most out of your multi-core system in SuperCollider, I recommend dual booting with a Linux distribution on your PC and running SuperCollider on that instead. A word of warning. Even though the README file states otherwise, 3.10.0 is seemingly not supported on an OS older than Windows 10. While it installs without incident, it consistently fails to launch on my machine running Windows 8.1. If you're running either Windows 7 or 8, I would stick to 3.9.3 for the time being, which is still perfectly up to date on most counts and is 100% compatible with this tutorial series. If you find yourself still using that trusty but ancient Windows XP, then 3.7.2 is the latest version you can run, which should still serve you just fine going forward in this series. The next step is to run the installer, granting whatever permissions it needs during the process. Once complete, launch the application named SCIDE, as you can see here in the SuperCollider directory found in Program Files, or Program Files x86 if you chose the 32-bit version. Once you take the time to admire the Qt-based IDE, select Boot Server under the Server menu. Windows will likely nag you at certain points, demanding for your permission to proceed. As implied by the action of booting the server, this is because SuperCollider makes extensive use of networking for reasons that will become clear later on in this series. Go ahead and grant that all that is asked of you, and presuming you find the little widget found at the bottom right of the IDE turning green with the various units of measurement showing fluctuating activity, then you're all set. For a true Hello World test, type the following in one line and press Shift Enter. And the code, if you can't read it on the screen, will be in the description below. Make sure that all of the capitalization and pretty much everything is exactly as you see here or will likely not work. All right, now we're hearing a sine tone. Once you tire of hearing that, press Control Period. If you don't hear anything, you're faced with an unresponsive IDE upon launch, or simply nothing's working at all, or SuperCollider crashes catastrophically every time you open it, there could be any number of potential issues stemming from how your network is managed to permissions across user accounts, to audio driver issues, to literally anything under the sun. If you have issues, please post them in the comments below, and I will try my very best to assist you. While SuperCollider is readily available for installation on Debian or any flavor of its subset Ubuntu, it is highly recommended that interested parties use the Ubuntu Studio distribution for working in the language. Notably, Ubuntu Studio comes pre-packaged with a low-latency Linux kernel, allowing for far better performance than sticking with the bog-standard Linux kernel as found in either stock Debian or Ubuntu. This low-latency kernel, along with features like the Supernova multi-threaded server that was later ported over to Windows and macOS to varying degrees of success, makes Ubuntu Studio an attractive choice of operating system to conduct work in the language. To install SuperCollider in Ubuntu Studio 18.10, go ahead and open a terminal emulator instance, like so, and enter the following. I'll post the code in the description below if you can't read it. All right, after typing it in, go ahead. You need to type in whatever your sudo password is. And yes, press enter to continue. Go ahead and wait. It's going to take a little while. And it looks like there's an error. Let's see. I seem to remember this happening before and it didn't hurt anything. So let's go ahead and continue by entering the following two lines. Again, I will post the lines in the description below. Sudo apt update, wait for that, see if we get any more errors. I think we will, considering we had an issue adding the PPA. Yep. All right. Well, let's just try installing SuperCollider, see if we can still do that. And we can. So yeah, let's go ahead, hit Y to continue. And just wait for the install to finish. Once the installation's finished, click the Ubuntu Studio icon at the top left of the toolbar, and then select Audio Production. And you should see SuperCollider. There it is. Click on it. Now you should be face-to-face with the IDE. Select Language, Boot Server. And there we go. We see all the values fluctuating in the server widget window here. They're all green, so everything should be good to go. Now for our Hello World test, go ahead and type the following in as you see here. Of course, all the code's in the description below. Make sure the capitalization, everything is exactly as you see it here. And oh yeah, hit Shift Enter to hear the wonderful sine tone coming out of the left channel. Press Control Period when you wish to stop the sound. Incidentally, you may have noticed that the version of SuperCollider installed is 3.8.0, which is about 2 years old at this point. If one wants a newer version of SuperCollider on Linux, one will have to build from source, a process beyond the scope of this tutorial. 3.8 is still recent enough to be 100% compatible with this tutorial series. Later on, I may include a special episode on how to build SuperCollider from source, but till then, I recommend simply sticking to what is in the official repository. With any luck, you've been able to install SuperCollider on your operating system of choice and take it for a quick spin. In the coming weeks, I'll be covering more of the basics of the language, focusing on coming to grips with its unusually flexible syntax, as well as understanding its unique server-client architecture. The next several lessons will have us building gradually toward our first composition project. What we work on together will be simple in scope, but by the time we're finished, you'll have all the tools you need to expand on what we've accomplished and really make it your own. In the meantime, please hit that like button and subscribe to this channel to show your support for more interactive digital music and art content from us at Null State. Also, Make sure to check out our Facebook page and webpage to stay up to date on all of our upcoming events, workshops, and concerts. The links to both being in the description below. Until next Tuesday!